Looking at let us see solutions. This is chapter number 11, input output in C. Disk IO, ARGC, ARGV, point out the errors. So what is the error here? I don't find any error here. It is perfectly fine. File pointer fopen. The only thing is stdio.h has to be included. In this, what is the error? The double is equal to sign is the error. It has to be single and there has to be some extension here. Then this is a code in which we just have to see here. Okay, everything is fine. Only you need to use the capital null, because this, you know, this is a macro and this null means this has been defined as zero. So capital null should be used. Then stdio.h, try c, trial.c, rr. So both the file are open. No problem with fp. This will be assigned to fp. Then again, this will be assigned to fp. There is no problem. The problem is here. In fclose, you know, both the files are being pointed by fp. There is no error as such. But for fclose, we have to use separately for fp and ft. These two cannot be done. Then we have again some ac, av0, no problem with that. This is argument, number of arguments in command line. When you run the C program in command line, you write the, so say like this. You write the name of the program, then you have number of counts and the variables. So these variables, how many variables, or you can say how many strings you are giving. This is actually this integer number. And these 1, 2, 3, this is an array. So this AV is there. So you can easily print this D and this AV0 with percent %s. The macro file is defined in which of the following files? Macro file is defined in stdio.h. True and false. The disadvantage of high level disk input output function is that the programmer has to manage the buffers. The answer is false, because in high level we don't have to worry about the buffers, but in low level we do have to consider the buffer handling. If a file is open for reading, it is necessary that the file must exist. Yes, it is true. If a file opened for writing already exists, in its content would be overwritten. This is also true. For opening a file in append mode, it is necessary that the file should exist. This is false. If it is not existing, the file will automatically be created. On opening a file for reading, which of the following activities are performed? Opening a file for reading. The answer is the disk is searched for existence of the file, then the file is brought into the memory and a pointer is set up which points to the first character in the file. So all of the above is the answer. Which of the following are the correct ways of opening a file? We have a file pointer, all these. This is the command line version. Scanf, scanning of the file name. Here we are taking the file name, again taking the file name from the argument which is in the command line. And we are opening it with read mode, closing it. So there is no problem. All of the above is correct. Write a program to count the number of words in a given text file. So number of words, just consider this line. How many number of words are there? 1, 2, 3. But how do we know these are separate words? With this blank. So the logic will be, we'll try to see how many blanks are there. So we have to count the total number of words in a file, and just we are assuming that we can give some maximum character just to make our program some compactness, give some compactness. So we have a str file name, this we have created, then blanks, this blank which I was talking about. So we opened a file, we had a file pointer, we asked for the file name, and then we got the name, we opened it in the read mode. If it is not opening, we say there is an error and we come out. Otherwise, we start with blanks equal to 0. We take this from fs, the chunk, 100 chunk means 100 content in the str, which is the buffer. And then we just say len, because we know that it is transferred as slash r slash n. So we have to subtract 2. Now the length is there. Now from 0 to length, we just try to find out whether there is a blank or not. If there is a blank, we just increment the blank, right? This is what we have to do. Finally, we print the blanks here. Write a program to store every character typed at the keyboard into the file. The procedure should come to an end as soon as the character this is hit from the keyboard. So the program is something like this: store every character typed at the keyboard into a file. So we have stdio conio, we have again we have some file name, we have just restricted it to 67, we have a file pointer, some variable, character variable, we asked for the file name, we entered the file name, and then we try to open the file name in the write mode. If it is not opening, we raise some error and we come out. Otherwise, we ask the user to type some sentence, and we ask the user specifically that you have to give a tilde sign, tilde sign, so that we assume, the program assume that you have done your work. So here we start with while. When the get ch, until it is not this tilde sign, we take ch. If it is this slash r, that is the carriage return, we put a slash n, and we put character this slash n into, we just print this slash n, and then slash n has to be placed into fp, because as this slash r has to be given specifically, and then we continue. Otherwise, if it is not the case, slash r is not there, we just put the all the characters which we got into the fp, and finally we come out. So this is how we do this program. Write a program to remove all blank lines from a file. So how do we know that a line is blank? For example, this is a blank line. How do we know that? We'll see just now. This is a program to remove all the blank lines from the file. So we have stdio conio. Now we have two macros, printable and non-printable. This is a command line program. So this is file, this is source, and this is target. We'll take all the content which are not blank to the target file. So we have taken some variable. Here what we are doing is we are trying to find out that, because this is a command line, this is the file name, this is the first string, this is the second string. First string is what? It is the source. Then we have a target. So we have to see, this argument count has to be 3. Otherwise we just say that there is not enough parameter. So we take the first argument, this is argument 1, we try to open it. If it doesn't open, we raise an error and we come out. Then we say line equal to non-printable, and as we have just seen, we have described it as or defined it as a macro. Then we start taking character one by one till we reach end of file. If the character is not slash n, that is slash n is not there, that is carriage, this is line feed, then we assign this ch to stri and we increment i++. If it is space or tab, because a blank line can have spaces or a tab, then we assign printable now to line and we continue. So this we go on and on, otherwise we just place a slash 0 at the end. If the line is printable, we print this str and we transfer this str to this ft target, and then we do non-printable equal to line, and then we again reinitiate with I equal to 0, then we close the source and target. This is how we do it. Write a program to remove all comments from a C program file. So comment is specifically, we have to see for this a slash followed by a star, then all the contents we have to just skip or do something with them, and see that it must follow or it must end with a star and a slash. So we have to remove comments from a C program. This is stdio conio. We have a source and a target. So we have a source and target file. First of all, we ask the user to enter the C file name. We just took it with gets, try to open in read mode. Then if it is null, then we raise some error, we come out. Otherwise, we ask for the target file name. We again take the file name with gets and try to open it in write mode. Again, if it is some error, then we just come out. Then when from the source file, we take one by one character till we reach the end of file. If it is slash, see, now we are looking at slash. If it is slash, we check for the next one, next character. If it is star, this is the first checking, this is the second checking, we call a function which is called as incomment. We'll see about incomment in a bit. Otherwise, we just take this C to FT and D to FT. This C, the character, this one to FT is D to FT, because if they are not this slash and star, we just copy it to the target file. And we do it with others as far till the time we don't get the culminating or ending star and slash. This is what this incomment do. So this incomment function we'll just see, where first we have to close this. And this incomment function we have C and D, we get S from FS. And now if C is this one, means first one is this and the next one is this, then we understand, okay, now this is a comment. So inside this, all this get C has to be, driven out. And just we assign D to C and this FS to D, and again check for incomment. Write a program to encrypt and decrypt a file using an offset cipher. So what is an offset cipher? In an offset cipher, each character from a source file is an offset with a fixed value and then written to a target file. For example, say if we are taking A, then we are just adding 128. This is the offset, 128. So if it is B, we add 128 to it. This is how we have to. And when we decrypt it, we have to subtract all those with the encrypted version with 128. So this is stdio.h, conio.h. We have to encrypt and decrypt a file using offset cipher. We have a source and a target. So we have a source and a target file. So this is a command line version. We just check that whether you have given enough argument or not. Otherwise, we say please type like this in the command prompt. We try to open the first one, argument 1. If it is okay, FS is null. We say if it is okay. Otherwise, if it is not okay, we exit. Again, we take the second argument in the write mode, and if it is not opening, we say there is an error, we come out. Then the argument C can be C and capital C. So what we are trying to suggest here is, for C, if C is there, we are, means for C and D, we are, for C we are encrypting, for D we are decrypting. So we have to check for the third argument also. So for C, we will code it. For any other then C in this capital C, we decode it. We close the file now. Now we have to see about this code and decode. So we just take all, one by one character from the source file till we reach the end of file, and we just add a 128 character to it and put the character into the target file. Similarly for decoding, we take one by one character, we decrypt, we subtract 128 and again put the character to the FT, means target file. A similar version, or you can say a flavor, is a substitution cipher. So in this, each character read from the source file is substituted by a corresponding predetermined character, and this character is written to the target file. For example, if we have A, we have decided just that A, for A, all A, will put an exclamation mark, right? So wherever A is there, exclamation mark has to be, means A has to be replaced with the exclamation mark. Similarly, we have decided that B has to be changed to this file, and like this. So what we will do, encrypt and decrypt, again the same scenario will be there. We'll stdio, conio, these are two files for source and target. This is a command line argument. So if it is not 4, we say please enter like this. This C and D is for coding and decoding, encrypting and decrypting. So we take this argument 1, we try to open. If it is not, we give an error, we come out. We try to open the second one in write mode. If it is this, there is an error, we come out. Then if this is C, means we want to encrypt it, we go to this function code. We want to decrypt it, we go to decode function. Then we close it. So we have to see this code and decode function, and we have to close this. So this code function does what? In this coding, we have to just put this array, two arrays. Why? Because we have decided this has to be replaced by this one. Say P has to be replaced by 2, like this. So all these characters have to be taken into a static array. And now, because this cannot be given, this is a special way, we have to give two slashes. Similarly for slash and slash T, that is why we have taken it separately. Now for every character, we go from 1 to 1, right? And we put the, take the character from array 1 and put the similar character from array 2 to the target file. This is what is done. In decode, what we do, again we have two characters, and this similar for the special characters which is understood by only the compiler. So here what we do, so one more thing was remaining in this. What we have done here is, because this is a source file, and we have just seen this, that we are transferring this, say this position, I'll show you here. So we have to take exactly this position, and we have to replace this with the exact replica, or you can say the decided character replacement. So now let us come to decode. Decode has similar characters and we have placed it like this. In decode, what we'll do here is, in decode, we'll just take the array 2, see, here we have taken array 1. The same character from array 2 has to be replaced by the character at array 1. This is the final solution. So this is all about the discussion we just had, and this is the solutions, and we'll be taking one more discussion of this. Till then, thank you so much and take care of yourself.